Today we're going to be reviewing Quillbot, the AI writing tool that helps writers rewrite and rephrase their content. Quillbot's main feature is the paraphraser, which lets you rewrite content and paraphrase it into various different styles. So in this case, we take a sample paragraph, and you can see how the content is rewritten on the right. You can choose how many synonyms are replaced within the text. The higher the value, the more changes are made to the text, but the less accurate it is compared to the original. You can also change the various modes on the top here. So you have the standard mode. You can make it your content more fluent. You can change it into formal content to make it more professional. You can simplify it as well. Make it sound more creative. Expand it to make it longer. And shorten it to make it more concise and to the point. And as you can see here on the right side, the content is constantly updating with the changes. Quillbot also has a grammar checker that lets you check your text for common grammar errors. All of the errors show up inline, and you can choose to fix all errors or individually highlight errors and correct them. Unlike other grammar editors that show you all of the errors in a nice sidebar so that you can see them all at once, Quillbot's grammar checker only lets you correct all of the errors at once or see individual errors when you hover over them. So this is an improvement that Quillbot can make. Quillbot also has a plagiarism checker that will scan your text and compare it to billions of other documents, websites, etc., so you can make sure that you're writing original content. Unfortunately, Quillbot's plagiarism checker only gives you 20 pages of scanning per month if you subscribe to the premium plan, and these can be consumed quite quickly. As you see, this one scan of a 1,200-word document used 4 of my pages for the month. The great thing about this plagiarism checker is the report card at the end, so you can see where the content was copied. I've posted this article on another of our websites, so you can see there's 100% match rate. The summarizer is another unique tool of Quillbot's that, similar to the paraphraser, lets you distill your content down to its essence. You can enter text here, select some keywords that you want to focus on, perhaps you know what the content's supposed to be about, and then you can get a paragraph summary or key sentence summaries. So these are great if you have several paragraphs of text or an essay and you want to make it into a few bullet points or a paragraph. It doesn't really work well for a single paragraph. As you can see here, it essentially just copies the sentences, both for key sentences and paragraph, into the summary. So not a great tool for summarizing just a single paragraph, but a great tool for longer content. The citation generator is another tool that the premium version of Quillbot offers. It's pretty standard as far as citation generators go. Nothing too exciting here. You can enter source URLs and documents and journals and things like that, and then choose the style of citation that you want, and then copy it once you're done. The final unique tool of Quillbot's is the co-writer tool, which basically distills all of their other functionalities into one easy tool, but adds a research tool as well. In this case, you can do research from within Quillbot, so you can search the web for various topics. In this case, I'm looking up flu shots just to get an idea of what kind of content Quillbot will generate. And we've used this test for similar AI content writing tools, as you can see in our other videos. As you can see, a lot of generic topics, a lot of research comes up, very in-depth in this case, but you can copy the full article, highlights from the article, topics, and then, of course, use the other tools of Quillbot's, like the paraphraser and summarizer here on the bottom of the screen in the center, to rewrite the text from your research. That's a little bit questionable in terms of original content and copyright infringement. Obviously, since you're doing research from the internet and copying from those sources, you can include the citations. But when you're paraphrasing and summarizing, it kind of gets a little bit sketchy in the sense that you're not really writing your own content. Yeah, you're researching it, but you're letting the tool paraphrase, which may or may not include the too much of the information from the other sources. The grammar checker is also included within this tool. as well as a suggest text functionality, which lets Quillbot try and predict what the next sentence or part of a sentence should be. So you can keep pressing suggest text, and it's going to suggest options of what to select next. And you can either use this content, write your own similar content, or take this content that it suggests and paraphrase or summarize it, just as you have for the rest of the content. Quillbot offers a Chrome plugin that integrates with almost any form on the internet, including Google Docs. So this is where Quillbot actually becomes really useful, because you can, as you're browsing the internet, as you're writing emails, as you're using Google Docs to edit your content, it can show all of the suggestions in line. And unlike the web tool, the Chrome plugin actually has a sidebar, which is really useful. So you can see all of the suggestions all in one easy place and see a summary. So you can quickly scroll through its suggestions and figure out if those changes in your text are needed or wanted. Of course, the Quillbot plugin has all of the other capabilities of Quillbot. It can change and rephrase your content with different modes, in this case standard, but you can choose fluency, simple, all the other ones. And you can change the number of synonyms that the text is being replaced with. All of this is integrated right into the Chrome plugin. As I mentioned, it also integrates with Gmail and other online forums, but the Gmail interface isn't as robust as we would like it to be. As you'll see once I finish typing this email, the suggestions are actually fairly generic and shallow. We're using Grammarly, of course, side by side here, and you can watch our review of Grammarly versus Quillbot on our channel. But when I go down to the little Quillbot icon in the bottom right here in a second, you'll see it's telling us to go to the main Quillbot website because the Chrome plugin is not robust enough to offer real suggestions for this email. Quillbot also has a Word plugin, but it's not very robust. First, it takes a while to actually install it. You have to go to Insert, Get Add-ons, Office Add-ins, Quillbot, and then add it from here. And once it's installed and you've logged in, it's also a pain to use. It really only has some of the basic functionality of the web editor. The paraphraser, you obviously can choose between different modes and synonyms, but it also only has a grammar checker and then summarizer as well. And it's not as intuitive to use. You can select a paragraph in your text, and it will show up in the paraphraser, and then that's where you can change your mode and synonyms, but it's all kind of jammed together in this small little sidebar widget. And it doesn't offer any of the other functionalities like the research tool with the co-write or the plagiarism checker or any of those cool features. So I'd still rely on the web editor. The Word plugin still has a long way to go. With regard to the pricing, Quillbot actually is fairly reasonable compared to a lot of other tools out in the market. They have a free plan, which is fairly limited, because it only allows you to paraphrase 125 words and 1,200 words in the summarizer. But they with their premium plan, you have unlimited words. So there are no limits except for the plagiarism checker and for the summarizer with the 6,000 words per run. In terms of pricing, as you can see here, the monthly plan, annual plan, and semi-annual plans are all fairly reasonable, especially if you only plan to use Quillbot for a set period of time, like 2 months, 6 months, etc. Overall, we think Quillbot is a great tool for those looking for a tool that can rewrite and rephrase existing content. It's not a tool that writers can use to create new content or generate new content ideas, unlike some of the other AI content writing tools out there. However, it's got a great rephraser, great summarizer, the research tool with the co-write product is also pretty appealing if you're trying to do everything from research, summarizing, citations, all in one tool. We don't recommend it if you're looking for a high quality grammar checker. It does do a decent job with grammar checking, but you can get a lot of those features from other free tools like Grammarly's free Chrome plugin, or even Microsoft Word's built-in editor. And the plagiarism tool also is a bit limiting, since you can only run 20 pages per month. Otherwise, you have to buy more pages. Overall, like I said, price is affordable when it comes to AI content writing tools. We'd recommend Quillbot if you're looking for just a tool to fill in that gap of you have existing content and you need it to be rewritten for various reasons, or you want it to be better written or simplified or things like that. Thanks for watching, and for more videos like this, please like and subscribe. Thanks.